Hello, I'm Joe. I'm a solution architect at Hewlett Packard Enterprise. Today I'm going to talk to you about OneView, our infrastructure management solution. OneView is quite a mature product. It's been in the market for around 4 to 5 years now, and we use it as the basis for monitoring and managing a number of products within the HPE portfolio. It's also a constituent part of the Synergy platform. OneView has a few key unique features, but before I get onto the features, I want to explain to you how OneView does what it does. OneView provides a consistent interface for connecting to our server products like HPE Blade System, Apollo, and DLs, our storage environments, 3PAR and Nimble, and our networking technologies, both in the form of Virtual Connect, FlexFabric top of rack, and a few select third-party solutions to provide a consistent interface within that data center. OneView lets us interact with a number of third-party vendor solutions and a number of software providers through a single REST API. That single interface is one of the key features of the HPE OneView solution because it gives us consistency across all of these environments. There are not needs for a separate API for each of these. Not one tool for the server environment and a different tool for the networking environment. OneView gives us that single view of everything. The REST API is also how the user interface is accessed. So the same things that are available natively within OneView's user interface are available to scripts and to third-party integrations. This has really driven the growth of quite a mature ecosystem around OneView and the support of a number of different management and monitoring tools and provisioning tools as well, such as Ansible, Chef, and Puppet. To do this, OneView leverages a few key principles. The first is this ability of having software-defined profiles for everything in the environment. You will have a profile for an individual server, a profile for a volume on a storage array, a profile for a network connection. These profiles can be aggregated up into templates to make things easy to repeat and to reduce operational overhead and ensure operational consistency. I can take a simple template that contains values for an individual property, and I can deploy those many times to stamp out multiple instances of the same profile. That massively improves my ability to automate an environment and deliver infrastructure quicker to the line of business to deploy applications onto. What I can also do is if I'm making a change, if I want to change a property for something else, when I change the template, I can make sure that that gets automatically updated into all of its deployed profiles. Again, ensuring consistency, making it easier to make changes within that environment. OneView also provides an ability to have a global search function. Now, the global search function allows a user to log into OneView, enter in some parameters such as a MAC address or a worldwide name associated to a volume, and pull out all of the resources that relate to that environmental parameter. That makes it much easier to diagnose problems quicker. And partnered with our activity log, which records all of the changes to both profiles, templates, and physical assets, you can track the changes in your environment much, much better than we would be able to were it not for this global search. We also have the ability to use map view within OneView, which allows us to relate different components together through those sort of common elements like profiles, templates, and hardware attributes. For instance, we could work out whether doing a particular firmware upgrade would affect my ability to provision a certain network. Is that network going to be affected if I change the firmware on these hosts? What is the scope of a network parameter change? How many hosts will it affect? What storage devices are reliant on that network being provisioned? All of these attributes that are hard to interrelate when you have multiple tools become much simpler when we move to HPE OneView. A great example of how we can enforce this operational consistency could be in SAN provisioning, for instance. You may have a blade enclosure with multiple hosts, all running a virtualization software. These can be connected to SAN infrastructure that is managed by HPE OneView, and all of that is connected to storage arrays, again, under the management of HPE OneView. When I create a new profile on one of these hosts, for a storage connection, all of the necessary SAN zoning information goes into the SAN through the creation of that profile, and then a data volume, for instance, gets spun up on the storage array here. That can all be done from a single line of code through the OneView REST API in a way that we've not been able to do with multiple disparate tools. That's really the advantage of HPE OneView. Another use case could be the facilitation of adding a new network to connect into some of these server environments. Typically, I'll have a compute node connected to a pair of networking switches. These might be cross-connected as well. When I provision a new network on one of these switches, what we're able to do within HPE OneView is make sure that the host is receptive of that network, so it has a new port on that network. The switch expects the network to be present as well, and we do those connections through that server profile. I might add in a line that says, hey, there's my new server profile connection to this particular network, and OneView makes that provisioning step happen either through addressing these modules as Virtual Connect or as Flex Fabric, whichever is most appropriate for that particular deployment. If you want to find out more about what OneView can do, you can go to the hpe.com/OneView website, where there are a number of videos, white papers, and further information on HPE OneView. I hope you found this useful.